This is the Inspection Series Automated Delivery Table. After 3 years of development with ATS Automation, Shoreline Power Group, and Bruce Power, the tooling and innovation team are on the precipice of launching this industry-changing innovation. This automated delivery table will mark the first time robotics are used on a reactor face anywhere in the world.
One of the challenges that we've had in the past is assuring that we have reliability and consistency between each reactor refurbishment. So we went down the route of automation, where we're helping some of our skilled trades improve reactor refurbishments by having automated tooling. During the removal series, we're taking aged reactor components and removing them to install new reactor components. And in between, we do an inspection series. Reactor components, they've been running for about 50 years now. So when we do remove them, we got to validate that the reactor itself is in a state that is ready to accept new components. Once we've confirmed during inspection series that the reactor is in a good condition for new components, we get into installation. And installation takes inputs from the inspection, so critical dimensions are provided during the inspection series to install the new reactor components, and then go into installation of fuel channels, which include end fittings, clandestine tubes, and pressure tubes as well. And this is very critical because we're trying to assure that our reactors run until 2064 to provide Ontario with clean energy for the years to come.
We learned a lot from Unit 6 during the removal and in the inspection series. It was a pretty significant challenge, but we've incorporated all of those lessons into the inspection tool set here in this new innovation. And really the three big things we're looking for in this new innovation: a significant reduction in dose to the workers, more consistency with inspection and conditioning, a reduction in overall series duration.
Now that we're using the robot doesn't need to be behind shielding. It's able to pick up the bore gauge, extend into the reactor, take the measurements, and provide some pretty consistent results. The robot's able to do it half the time than what it took the workers to do. It's not replacing the workers or replacing trades. It's more of a tool. You're still going to have trades working in a remote control center and provide input and actually operate the tooling.
On MCR6, we didn't have the robot involved. We had to do a lot more hoisting and rigging activities. We were always up in the face. We were always in the line of fire, trying to stay away from radiation beams. Now with this robot, the worker's gonna be down below. They're not gonna have to get up near the reactor face and take so much dose. We still need to get through the training process and get all the workers dialed in on how to use the tooling and how to set up the tools. But up to this point, I believe the tools are ready to go.
We worked very effectively on collaboration on this innovation with our partners like ATS Industrial Automation, Shoreline Power Group, our Bruce Power Engineering, Tooling and Innovation team, and last but not least, with the support and hard work of our trades.
It's very reassuring for us to have all these players involved in the whole team, and it's gonna help us execute the job perfectly in the end.